Yo, what's going on, ladies and gents? Welcome back to another rebuild. I did say I was going to do a Romeo Doubs rebuild because he's been eating and Packers are my team. And we're not going to really do too much. We're really just going to make sure we develop him nicely. I wish I could give Doubs, like, if I gave him like star development, would he take off? That's the question. Like, I don't know if he'd take off if we gave him star development, but team though looks pretty solid, I'd say. I mean, like, the team is playing good in real life. Could be a little bit better. We also did sign Eric Wilson, which is surprising that Madden's already got him in there. And defense though is like pretty solid. I mean, granted, another D tackle number two would be okay, but our D line's okay, you know, overall. And then special teams to special teams, they have Romeo Doubs kick returning. That's interesting. I'm going to put Amari Rodgers there because that's what he's doing. Aaron Rodgers co-signed him being a being a special teamer. So, and then when it comes to the offense, what we're going to do here with the slot wide receiver, so Doubs will be here. I want to put Doubs as receiver number two. I think that'd be fair. Dude, the fact that all of our receivers are like just some like low dev guys, just like, it's just crazy to me. But we're going to make sure Mr. Doubs himself, number 87, is, they say he's a deep threat. He has 92 speed, so not too bad. So we're going to make him have star dev and see if him having that. I'd rather give him hidden, but we're going to see if how he does with being having star dev. Yeah, they don't have anything else. So we give him star. I mean, because he has been performing well, even though it's still early into the season. But we put him as star dev. Offensive line is looking pretty good. We're gonna fix up the depth chart just to make sure that he's starting. And wide receiver, yeah, he'll start over Cobb, and then that'll be fine right there. And then tight end, we'll just put Tonyan, have the tight ends like that, perfect. And then we're gonna have to obviously fix up the lineup again once we go to regular season. All right, our season goal, we always make the playoffs, so it'll be to win the Super Bowl. I mean, we have Aaron Rodgers, so that's always should be the goal, to win the Super Bowl. And we get to upgrade of our players. We'll have Rashawn Gary, who's leading the NFL in sacks right now in real life with 5. So that should be good. Look at the lineup again. Mr. Matt LaFleur. And he's not wide receiver number 2. Why not? We're going to have to find that out. I think everyone that was on the team is still on the team, so that's good. Yeah, everyone that was there is still there, so that we'll take that. And then defense, running a base 3-4. Okay, so that's fine. And we have Quay Walker as inside linebacker number 2. He's been pretty fast, pretty good for us. So let's fix up the depth chart, and then we should be solid to go. So they made Cobb number 2 again, but we'll put Doubs there. So Doubs is number 2, and let's see how we do. So we made the playoffs, going 12-5, facing the Washington Commanders. So pretty good. I mean, another W season. I don't know what our record is or what our seeding is. Maybe number 2? Yeah, we're the number 2 seed. Cowboys are the number 1 seed. And the Bears also made the playoffs, sneaking in with Justin Fields. And let's see how we did in the league. Davante Adams, of course, did amazing. Aaron Donald had 27 sacks. Russell Wilson went sick, but not in real life that would happen. So I'm going to leave that there. But statistically, our offense was 6 overall. Aaron Rodgers was 2nd in passing touchdowns. Okay. And our defense was 4th. We had a top 5 offense and defense. 44 touchdowns, 16 picks for Aaron Rodgers. Only got sacked 24 times. Aaron Jones, 1,300 yards. A.J. Dillon had 400. Romeo Doubs, 57 catches, 821 yards, 2 touchdowns. Pretty solid. I like it. Randall Cobb had 1,100 yards, and so did Randall Cobb had 1,300. I mean, Allen Lazard had 1,300 with 16 touchdowns. That's pretty awesome. Preston Smith and Rashawn Gary both 8. And Kenny Clark also had. Kenny Clark had 10 sacks. Rashawn Gary had 13.5. Preston Smith had 14. That's awesome. Jair had 3 picks. So our guys came back and really did their thing. But Romeo Doubs, 800 yards, 57 catches, 2 touchdowns. Even though the touchdown count was kind of low, that's still pretty good in my books. I feel like that's gonna help us out in a long way. And now Doubs is 76, so I'm really liking that. Defense, Quay Walker now fits our scheme, and then rest of the defense is not too bad. We picked up a guy named Tonga as a D tackle, but Eric Stokes and Razul Douglas are chilling with Jair. So that's pretty good to see. And let's see how they perform against the Washington Commanders as we're in Lambeau Field. We won 31-29. Never facing the Niners. So we're always our bane when we play against them. And we have a tendency of losing to them only in the playoffs, really. Carson Wentz and Aaron Rodgers battled out. Carson Wentz got sacked 4 times. Aaron Rodgers got sacked once, but he also threw a pick. Damn, Aaron Jones, 17 carries, 127 yards, 2 touchdowns. Unstoppable. Randall Cobb, 9 catches, 95 yards, 2 touchdowns. Romeo Doubs, man, 6 catches, 78 yards. Insane. Allen Lazard had a good game, too. 6 catches, 73 yards. I'm liking that. I'm liking what I'm seeing from the team here. And then Devondre Campbell had a lot of tackles. Preston Smith with 2.5 sacks. Kenny Clark with a sack as well. And Rashawn Gary with 0.5 sack. And Cameron Curl with a pick. So we ended up winning that 31-29, which is good. And now as we face the Niners, who have a solid defensive line, a solid offense, we're going to see if we can be able to actually, you know, beat this team. We do. We ended up winning 38-35. We're facing the Cowboys in their stadium, away from home. And winner of this goes to the Super Bowl. So that's pretty tough to see. And divisional, we ended up winning just by 3. So Aaron Rodgers had 1 touchdown, got picked off once, and got sacked 3 times. While Jimmy G got picked off twice and didn't get sacked. Aaron Jones, 20 carries, 70 yards, 3 touchdowns. Then Marlon Mack and Jimmy Garoppolo shared rushing touchdowns. Debo had 8 catches, 147 yards, 1 TD. Pretty good game from Allen Lazard, 6 catches, 96 yards. Randall Cobb with 10 catches, 77 yards, and a touchdown. Romeo Doubs, 7 catches, 69 yards. All we need from him. So pretty interesting to see from that. Defense, Nick Bosa was killing us, and so was Eric Armstead. And then Jair got a pick, and so did Rudy Ford. And then Talona Hufanga got a pick as well. But we ended up winning, so now we're in the conference championship against the Cowboys. We're away from home, so this should go either way. I don't think we're really suffering from injuries. Maybe to AJ Dillon. I forgot Sammy Watkins injured. AJ Dillon's out for the rest of playoffs. So we can honestly make Kylan Hill return. We probably can't. But we got a little bit of some injuries here. But I forgot Sammy Watkins on the Packers. Like, I don't know why. But let's see, conference championship against the Cowboys. Let's see how we perform. And we ended up winning 35-28. So we made the Pro Bowl. I mean, we made the Super Bowl in year one of this rebuild. Now, I don't even know if this is a rebuild. Like, I don't even know what to call it. But we don't even have to look at the Pro Bowl roster because we're in the Super Bowl. So I guess that matters more. But Super Bowl trip, the veterans are here. We've had a pretty clean sweep of playoffs. And we'll probably be facing the Chiefs, which we will be. We won 35-28. Aaron Rodgers and Dak both threw 4 touchdowns. Aaron Rodgers had a bit more yards, but Dak got sacked 3 times. Aaron Jones had 20 carries, 120 yards, and 1 touchdown. He's been running the ball really well. Allen Lazard, 8 catches, 129 yards, 1 touchdown. Noah Brown, unstoppable. 6 catches, 107 yards, 2 touchdowns. Randall Cobb, 6 catches, 99 yards, 2 touchdowns. Dalton Schultz, actually 8-2. And I don't think Doubs got any love, unless he's injured. Doubs didn't get any love, guys. That's shocking. Preston Smith and Rashawn Gary both came up big for us. But where was Doubs in that game, in the conference championship, where we needed him? Let's see, injury report. Hopefully he didn't actually, like, get blicked. No, he didn't get blicked. He just didn't get the ball. So that's cool. This is so cool. But we're facing the Chiefs in the Super Bowl. This should be pretty interesting to see how we do. They went 15-2. Pat threw 40 touchdowns, 10 picks. We threw 44 touchdowns and 16 picks. So Super Bowl, I don't know what number. Let's see how we do. And we ended up winning 48-42. So that's a W. Breece Hall won Offensive Rookie of the Year. Aaron Rodgers won Super Bowl MVP. Aiden Hutchinson with Defensive Rookie of the Year. No Packers players got any awards, but we won the Super Bowl. I mean, We won the Super Bowl, so I don't know what else to say. Like, we got the Super Bowl. Like, it's a W. Like, there's not really much we can do. We just went all the way. And I'm going to see how this game went. It was a high-scoring game for sure. Postseason. So, let's see. Jesus. Mahomes threw 5 touchdowns, but 4 interceptions. And Aaron Rodgers threw 4 touchdowns and 1 interception. And also got sacked once. So, they threw a total of 9 touchdowns and 5 interceptions in this game. Just airing it out. 9 carries, 95 yards, 1 touchdown for Clyde Edwards-Helaire. 22 carries, 94 yards for Aaron Jones. Patrick Taylor had a touchdown backing us up. Travis Kelce, 12 catches, 121 yards, 2 touchdowns. Allen Lazard, 6 catches, 104 yards, 2 touchdowns. MVS, 5 catches, 96 yards, a touchdown. And so did Mecole Hardman. But Randall Dobbs, 3 catches, 49 yards. He got some touches in the Super Bowl, which is lit. Mercedes Lewis had a touchdown as well in the Super Bowl. So did Clyde Edwards-Helaire. Christian Watson even got some touches too. But Frank Clark got the only sack of the game, but the amount of interceptions. Legarius Sneed had a pick. Devonta Campbell had a pick. Rasul Douglas had a pick. Jair had a pick. And so did Adrian Amos. So, damn. That is crazy, I have to say. We went all the way. Won the Super Bowl. I think that'll make like people retire and stuff like that. Which is totally, totally fine. But Romeo Doubs is now a 79 overall with how he played. Allen Lazard became a star too. So, offensive line upgrading pretty nicely. So, I mean, we got a Super Bowl out of that. We got a whole Super Bowl out of that whole trip. So, I could end it there, but I'm interested to see how well Romeo Doubs can perform in his second year. So, we have about $67 million to kind of renegotiate with people. Elgton Jenkins, since he just won a Super Bowl, I think it's fair if we give him a nice hefty deal. So, we get our right tackle back. Adrian Amos is 30 years old. He wants a 3-year deal. I give it to him. He played pretty well. Allen Lazard, he doesn't want to stay, but Allen Lazard, if we give you this deal, will you stay? Well, he's going to test free agency. He's like, nah, I'm good. Robert Tonyan definitely is going to want to stay. I think Big Dog definitely retired. So Robert Tonyan, we're going to have to use you a lot. Sammy Watkins, you're gone. Dean Lowry, I mean, you helped out the defense, so I have no problem re-signing you. And then Jerron Reed, Chris Barnes. Chris Barnes would be good for depth. He also got injured, so we're going to get him back, so we have that good rotation there. And then we got Jerron Reed, who's interested. We got also Eric Wilson, who's interested. We don't need all those guys, though. Yosh Nijman, though, I think could be great to re-sign, which we do. Rudy Ford, Keyshawn Nixon. A lot of guys here are just the backups, really. Keyshawn Nixon, I think, would be solid to keep. So we get Keyshawn Nixon back, and then I know we have Devontae Wyatt, but maybe we'll just work with Jerron. I mean, we could let Jerron Reed go. Eric Wilson, we could let go too. And then the backup safety, Rudy Ford, we'll just take him as well, see if he wants to resign. He's not interested. And then Tipa Galilei, Dallin Leavitt's not even asking for much. So if we give you 1 year, he does come back on that. And then Tipa Galilei, Tyler Davis. So I know we lost Big Dog. So maybe if we get Tyler Davis to stick to the team, he's going to test free agency as well. So, okay. So we did pretty solid re-signing players. And hopefully we still have Aaron Rodgers. Oh, I think he retired. I think Aaron actually retired. Okay. So why would you do that, Aaron? Why would you leave us like that? You get the Super Bowl and you dipped? He really got the Super Bowl and said, all right, I'm out. I'm heading out. I'm going to catch y'all. Wow, we have this whole team still sitting here. He left us with Jordan Love. Defense is still pretty good, though. But we have, damn, he really left us with this team to work with. Oh, man. Obviously, we're going to need a quarterback. But what draft picks do we even have to even work with? That's the thing. What draft picks? We have the 32nd. See if we give a third for a QB, make them challenge, I guess. Or maybe like quarterback. A third for a QB sounds crazy, but I mean, like, do we just stick with Jordan Love just for the heck of it and just like go on with that? I honestly think so. And we could just draft a receiver. Yeah, so we'll draft the receiver. We'll actually use the draft and just work on the team. So let's head into the draft. I cannot believe Aaron Rodgers is like, all right, bet I'm out. Got the Super Bowl. We good out here. So, all right. So what we're looking for is probably a receiver. We don't need a running back. I would say a quarterback, but honestly, might as well get someone in the third round to just back up Jordan Love. Receiver, though, we got Rakeem Jarrett, A.T. Perry, and Josh Downs. Honestly, I think I'm going to go with Josh Downs. I think he'll F catch in traffic. He's fast, but like, the heck? Dude, what the heck kind of stats was that? Even Rakeem Jarrett looks better. Yeah, we're going to get Rakeem Jarrett. He has normal dev. About to be like another Romeo Doubs type of player, but we pick him up. And then second round here, I feel like we'll go, I would say, nah, not quarterback yet. We're not going to go quarterback yet. You don't need a corner either. I want to say we do need a safety, though. We do need a safety, but there's not anyone really good there. Right end, there's nothing really good there. Offensive line, we could get, what's his name? Caleb Chandler. He'd be pretty solid. Normal dev, so he's just there for depth. I think will work out for us. And then with this next pick here, we'll draft a QB just to have that competition going with Jordan Love. So let's see what is there. Quarterback, Jaren Hall. Oh my gosh, these guys are not that solid. So we're just not going to go for anyone there. And they're saying we need a backup center. Cedric Van Praan. I know he's going to suck, but we're going to pick him up. He's just there for depth. And then we're going to sim through the rest of this draft. So draft recap, we ended up not getting a quarterback. Rakeem Jarrett was a 74. Chandler was a 73. This center was a 58, so that sucks. That sucks, but it's a backup center nonetheless. And now it'll be week one. Jordan Love still needs some competition before he just takes over with the comp or with the team. But we're just going to probably sign. I feel like Spencer Rattler probably didn't get drafted. And since I saw his name, we're gonna pick him up. All right, so Spencer Rattler looked like he got picked up somewhere. I have no idea where. But another player we're probably going to try to put onto the team is Josh Dobbs, just because that last name. So that's QB number two. And I don't even know if we still have our kicker. If we still have our kicker, what's his name? Matt Crosby? I think it's Matt Crosby. I'm like tweaking. Is it Matt Crosby? Why can't I remember? I'm drawing a blank on his name. Yeah, we don't have Crosby anymore, so we're gonna pick up a kicker. Matt Crosby, I think that's his name. So we're gonna pick up a kicker because, you know, he retired as well. He's like, all right, we got another ring. I'm Gucci. I'm out of here. So I'm like, all right, cool, bro. You do what you got to do. So picked up the kicker. And then we're going to pick up a third tight end just to throw into the squad. Adam Shaheen, just another big body. Throw him in there with Josiah DeGuara and Robert Tonyan. And now let's see if Jordan Love can help this team to victory. We actually went 12-5. Won the division. That's kind of shocking to me, not going to lie, but we'll take it. I mean, we'll take that. I guess Jordan Love got into his bag this season and was like, yeah, I'm going to prove everyone wrong, which is perfect for us because we're back in the playoffs. We're the defending champs, and our offense was finished fourth. Jordan Love, okay, not too bad, and our defense finished 16th, so defense took a little bit of hit, but 34 touchdowns, 9 picks for Jordan Love. He only got sacked 25 times, 109 pass rating, 1,400 yards, 7 TDs for Aaron Jones. AJ Dillon did okay backing him up. Romeo Doubs, 83 catches, 1,000 yards on the season, and 5 tutties. While Rakeem Jarrett, the rookie, had 77 catches, 1,000 yards, 8 touchdowns. Amari Rodgers did pretty solid too, and so did Christian Watson. Nice. Very nice to see here. Preston Smith had 11 sacks. Devonta Campbell led the team in tackles at 2 sacks and 1 pick. Rashawn Gary had 10.5 sacks. Kenan Clark had 8. Dean Lowry had 7. So these guys came to play, which helped us out a lot. And we only had 4 interceptions as a defense, so pretty interesting. Romeo Doubs, though, performed really, really well. And before we go into this defending our Super Bowl title. Romeo Doubs is now 80, so that's pretty solid to look at. And Jordan Love went from a 67 to 74, so he's been throwing the ball pretty well. And defense is the defense. These guys are going to be performing well, doing what they got to do. So we're going to take that. And yeah, let's see if we can make Aaron Rodgers proud as he's at home. So Vikings, let's see. 8-9 Vikings. We ended up winning 30-17. So now we're facing the Eagles at home. So Jordan Love wins his first playoff game as starting QB. Now we're facing Jalen Hurts and the Eagles. Let's see how we do in this game. We ended up winning 38-28. So now we're in a conference championship again against the Cowboys. And who were probably the number one seed. So they went 14-3. We have one new injury. Better not be our quarterback. John Runyon broke his ribs, out for 3 weeks. I mean, we have backups, so I'm not really worried about the left guard position. But against the Cowboys, winner goes to the Super Bowl. And we end up losing 49-28. So we're so close to having a repeat against the Chiefs, but we ended up losing to the Cowboys in the conference championship this year. So that's tough to see. But Pro Bowlers, Jordan Love made it, Aaron Jones made it. Romeo Doubs did not make it. Wow. Tight ends, none of our guys. David Bakhtiari, John Runyon. Right guard, nobody. Right tackle, Elton Jenkins made it. D-line, Kenny Clark, of course. Linebackers, none of our guys besides Preston Smith. Corners, none of our guys. Safeties, none of our guys. Interesting. So we had a good amount of Pro Bowlers. Not too bad. Not too bad, I'd say. And we had a breakout DB. Who was the breakout DB? Eric Stokes. Okay, so Eric Stokes was the breakout DB. All right, awesome to see. So let's see how these games went. I know we didn't repeat as Super Bowl champs, but we were very close to it. So against the Vikings, our opponents, Jordan Love threw 2 touchdowns, 2 picks. Kirk Cousins just threw 2 picks and got sacked 6 times. Rushing attack was good. Romeo Doubs, 9 catches, 118 yards, 1 touchdown. So he's become our number one guy. 2 sacks for Preston, 1 for Rashawn, 1 for Devontae. Okay. And then 1/2 for Kenny Clark and 1.5 for Dean Lowry, who's actually gotten to his bag, which is dope to see. Then against the Eagles, we won 38-28. Jordan Love threw 2 touchdowns, 1 pick. Jalen Hurts threw 2 touchdowns, 1 pick, and got sacked once. Rushing attack was pretty solid, though. Romeo Doubs led with the most yards. Okay, we'll take that. And then defense, Rasul Douglas had a pick. Devontae Wyatt had the only sack. Interesting. So a tight game, but we came away with it. But against the Cowboys, they blasted us. We threw 2 picks and got sacked 4 times. Well, Dak Prescott threw 3 touchdowns, 1 pick, and got sacked once. And Zeke actually went sick running the ball on us. Rakeem Jarrett did pretty solid. Allen Lazard's on the Cowboys. Wow. He joined the Cowboys and just did us in. Romeo Doubs had a pretty solid game too. And then defense. DeMarcus Lawrence had 3 sacks. So us losing our left guard must have did that to us, because we could not protect our quarterback at all. So that's actually very interesting how that came about. Romeo Doubs in 2 seasons almost picked up 2,000 yards. So he seems like the real deal.